we celebrate and tell the story of Jesus' birth. Please stand as you are able for confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, the world made flesh, our life and our salvation. Amen. Trusting the goodness and loving kindness, our God, our Savior, let us confess our sin. God of life,
you promised to give us great joy for all people and call us to be messengers of your peace.
We confess that you often
reward our joy, our resources, and our security. You nourish our minds and build barriers
and neglect the needs of our neighbors.
Thank you. Almighty God, you made this holy night shine with the brightness of the true light. Grant that here on earth we may walk in the light of Jesus' presence, and in the last day wake to the brightness of his glory. Through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Our first reading tonight comes from the ninth chapter of Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken, as on the day of midday. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our psalm to read responsibly this evening is Psalm 96. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth.
Sing to the Lord. Bless the name of the Lord. Proclaim God's salvation from day to day.
Declare God's glory among the nations and God's wonders among all peoples.
For great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised, more to be feared than all gods.
As for all the gods of the nations, they are but idols. But you, O Lord, have made the heavens.
Majesty and magnificence are in your presence. Power and splendor are in the sanctuary.
Ascribe to the Lord, you families of the peoples, ascribe to the Lord honor and power.
Ascribe to the Lord the honor due the holy name. Bring offerings and enter the courts of the Lord.
Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Tremble before the Lord, all the earth.
Tell God among all the nations, the Lord is King, the one who made the world so firm that it cannot be moved, who will judge the peoples with equity.
Let the heavens rejoice, and let the earth be glad. Let the sea thunder and all that is in it. Let the field be joyful and all that is therein.
Then shall all the trees of the wood shout for joy and triumph, O Lord. For you come to judge the earth.
You would judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with your truth.
Please stand for the gospel affirmation. Registered. Joseph also went to the town of Nazareth in Galilee, to Judea, to the city of David, called Bethlehem, because he was a descendant from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, while they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And the angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone all around them, and they were terrified. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David, a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest." Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors. When the angel had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went to the place and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. They know what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. The Gospel of Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated. Please join me in a word of prayer. Gracious God, on this holy night, we gather together to hear a word that will touch our lives, a word that will inspire us and lift us up. Word like the shepherds heard, that had them go with haste to Bethlehem and see the sign as it had been told them. Lord, we come looking for a sign, looking for a word that will lift our hearts and minds and spirits during these challenging days in our world. Lord, I pray that the words from my lips and the meditation of our hearts may be acceptable to you, our rock and our salvation. Amen. So the gospel reading tonight begins with this story of Joseph and Mary heading to be registered. It was required, so Joseph, being a faithful person, they went. And Mary was riding on a donkey. Raise your hand if you've ever ridden on a donkey. Uh-oh, right, yes. Riding on a donkey is not the most pleasant experience. It's a little bumpy. Now, as we heard earlier this morning that, am I good? Am I good? Okay, there we go. I need to have you guys tell me. Wave at me. I can't hear. Those of you who have been here for a while, you know that I need coaching sometimes because I get off script a lot. So anyways, back to the gospel. So Mary and Joseph are riding to Bethlehem, and she is on a donkey, greatly with child. And maybe because, you know, she became pregnant by the Holy Spirit, they didn't know the exact due date. And they thought, you know, we have time, we can make this trip. But no, when you're riding on a donkey, it can be a bumpy ride. And perhaps for a pregnant woman, it might have enhanced the process, if you know what I'm saying. And so they get to Bethlehem, and they go to the place where they think they can stay, and they're told, no, there's no room for you here. You'll have to stay in the manger. So what do? They go to the manger. And what happens? But Mary gives birth. I mean, in some ways, every time I hear this story, I'm thinking, how did this happen? How, without a midwife or anything, I mean, had Joseph had some knowledge? Was he able to be there? I mean, those of you women who have had children, your husband, was he helpful in the waiting, in the room when you were giving birth?
Absolutely.
Something must have happened. And Joseph must have figured it out. This story of the birth of Jesus is so powerful. And yet sometimes we think, oh, how sad it is that they had to have this in a manger. But hey, it was a blessing. Maybe if they would have stayed in Nazareth and not gone to Bethlehem, this wouldn't have happened. But hey, how would the shepherds have figured out where they are? I see this story of this birth as a blessing, not as a burden. For God can do amazing things. As the angel told Mary earlier, Gabriel said to her, with God, nothing is impossible. And so there they are in Bethlehem. And she gives birth to this baby boy and wraps him in cloths, binds him. And Joseph and Mary are there in the manger, perhaps with some animals around, and the child is put into a trough. A trough, a place where animals would feed. But what is Jesus not for us but the bread of life? He gives us that which we hunger for. And then the scene with the shepherds. They are there in the field watching their sheep by night. And what happens? But an angel comes to them and they are terrified. I don't understand why angels terrify so many. But they seem to be afraid when they see an angel. I would have to tell you, if you ever see an angel, rejoice. Give thanks. Because good news is coming your way. And so this angel comes and she says, do not be afraid. I have good news for you. In the town of Bethlehem, in a manger, lies the Lord, bound in wraps of cloth, and you are to go and seek him out. For this is a sign. This is a sign for you. And then with that angel, on top of everything else, comes a multitude of the heavenly host. Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom God favors.
Okay, at this point, where are you thinking the sheep are? I think they are scattered all over the place. But the shepherds are like, oh my gosh, we need to go. We need to check this story out. There's something amazing that has happened, and it's been told to us. Shepherds, lowly shepherds, that people do not think highly of. These shepherds have been given this message. What do? They go with haste. They go to haste to Bethlehem to see what they have been told. For a sign has been given to them, and it is about to turn their world upside down. Perhaps maybe one of the younger shepherds stayed around and kind of took care of the sheep that were still able to be gathered together. But the shepherds went, and when they got there and they saw Mary and Joseph and the baby in the manger, in the trough, they tell Mary and Joseph, you won't believe what happened to us, why we are here, because this angel told us about you. And they are probably as shocked as anybody else, Mary and Joseph. But what happens is that Mary takes all this in and ponders it in her heart. She takes what has happened and knows that this is what was meant to be. This is life changing. So tonight, what sign are you looking for? Are you here to hear a sermon that will knock your socks off? I'm not sure I'm that good. Are you here to hear the music that will touch your soul? Are you looking for something new, something that will inspire you, something will help you see what God is up to in your own life? Are you looking for a sign? Look no farther than the manger. Look no farther than the star in the sky. Look no farther than the word proclaimed. For God is doing amazing things. Even in the midst of things we cannot understand. The stole that I wear tonight, I purchased in Jerusalem. When I visit there and Bethlehem several years ago. Tonight I think about those people. I think about Christmas Lutheran Church in Bethlehem, who had a service and had the Christ scene, the Christ child, not in a manger, but in bubble, to signify the brokenness of that country at this time. We know that God can do amazing things. As Mary was told, nothing is impossible with God. Is it possible that this war can end? Is it possible that love can win the day? Is it possible? With God, nothing is impossible. So tonight, may the story of Jesus' birth stir your soul. May the message that you hear from me and from this entire service make a difference. And just by chance, may the message you hear personally inspire your heart. May you embrace that word and seek God each and every day of your life. For here is a sign for you. As siblings of Christ, God through Christ Jesus and the Holy Spirit loves you beyond all measure. and there is nothing you can do to stop that. It is more than a sign. It is power to be reckoned with. It is a power to change and touch your life. Be open, my siblings, to this good news. For you have been given a sign. In God's will. Please stand as you are able for the hymn of the day. O come, all ye faithful.
Yeah.
Rejoicing in God's good news of great joy for all people, we offer our prayers for ourselves, our neighbors, and the world God loves. Glory to you, God, for the song of the angels, proclaiming to the world Christ's holy birth. Give your church a joyful song to sing, that we bring the good news of peace and salvation to all people. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Glory to you, God, for the stars that shine in the depth of the night. Provoke awe in our hearts at the expansive mystery of the cosmos. Open us to find beauty in the clear darkness of night and in the first glimmers of dawn. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Glory to you, God, for the child born to us, who establishes a kingdom of justice and righteousness. Break bonds of oppression, bring reconciliation to warring lands, and establish peace from this time onward and forevermore, especially in Israel and Palestine, Ukraine, and Russia. Also for the volcanic eruption in Grindavík, Iceland, for those injured, grieving, or displaced by earthquake in northern China, especially amid freezing temperatures, for the ceasefire to hold and for fair elections in the Democratic Republic of Congo, for all left without power due to storms in the northeastern United States, for feeding ministries and those working to provide basic needs during the holiday season, and for families of all shapes and sizes, chosen families and friendships. Also for all experiencing grief, depression, loneliness, or need, hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Glory to you, God, for Mary's loving care. Lead us to tend to one another in time of need. Share the comfort of your presence with all people tonight who are alone or separated from loved ones due to estrangement, incarceration, or illness. We ask especially that you look on Aaron, Charlie, Mona, the family of Bob, Alexandria, Craig, Ricky, Kathy, Grace, Kevin, Ray, Stacy, Megan, Maggie, Steve, Eric, Nathan, Jan, Lindsay, Mildred, Toby, Maya, Nancy, Harvey, Dick, Brian, Luke, Mary, the family of Rich, Susan, Joshua, and those whom we name silently in our hearts. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Glory to you, God, for the faithfulness of the soldiers, for the shepherds in their vocation. Grant rest to many who feel exhausted from their work during this season, retail and restaurant workers, church musicians, administrative staff and clergy, organizers of charitable giving events, and service workers doing essential tasks. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Glory to you, God, for the multitude of the heavenly host. We rejoice in the zeal of all of your saints who have witnessed the appearing of your grace and who reveal to us your salvation for all. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Abide with us, O God of mercy, and receive our prayers according to your abundant grace.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us share the peace with one another and whatever way we feel comfortable.
Thank you. or you can stay back here.
What?
You mean grandma's going to be in the house?
Yeah.
and you are all welcome to feast at this table as children of mine. You may be seated. Just a couple of words. We have bread and we have gluten-free bread if needed. In the center of the communion tray, there is grape juice, and then on the after side is wine. Come, for all is prepared.
Thank you.
body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you and keep you in his grace always. Amen. Let us pray. Radiant God, with our eyes we have seen your salvation, and in this meal we have feasted on your grace. May your word take flesh in us, that we may be your holy people, revealing your glory made known to us in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. You may be seated for the announcements. January 24th, if you want to sign up for us. Our pantry is needing macaroni and cheese and canned soup. If you're able to bring that and donate it to the pantry, that would be greatly appreciated. Again, I hope that you received a candle when you came in. Yes, 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 somebody need a candle? All right, so here's how we do this. I will light my candle. And then I will hold my candle steadily as I best can. And each row will light from it. So remember that you light from the candle. The candle with the light stays still. So we do not get lots of wax on the floor or on the pews or wherever. So, in closing, receive this blessing. God bless you and keep you. Jesus grant you grace and truth. The Spirit send you forth upon your heart, peace upon your heart, now and forever.
Amen.
Our closing hymn is Silent Night, Holy Night. news.
Thanks be to God.